taking time to be here on time. There you go. Rob, if you would, start us off, please.
All right. I got a few cleanup items first, and I've already told a couple of y'all. Page 21 and 22 are duplicates. I've already marked them out in your hard copies, so we won't be addressing those at all.
21 and 22.
Page 21, not all right. Just the pages. And when we did this agenda, some things should be on the consent agenda that aren't, and that's page 10, 12, 13, 15, 16, and 17. Sorry, that's confusing, I know, but I wasn't here last week, and my nobody else had ever done this before, so.
10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15.
No, 10, 12, 13, 15, 16, and 17. They're all consent transfers.
And those will be included in the consent agenda?
Yes, sir.
Everybody had a chance to look over the consent agenda? Do I hear a motion to approve the consent agenda?
Move for approval.
Got a motion to approve. Got a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carried. Thank you.
Okay, let me take these out real quick so I don't ask you guys to look at them again. Okay. Next, we have the schools, and we can take them one, you know, individually or as a group.
What's the pleasure?
As a group.
As a group.
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Is that a motion that we approve them as a group?
Yes, or just I'm sorry. Well, Mr. Chairman, I make a motion we approve as a group.
Okay. Okay. And you're second. Okay. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries.
All righty, we're on page 19 now. And these are budget, 19 and 20 are both budget amendments from the Sheriff's Department.
Discussion?
Move for approval.
Got a motion to approve, a second. Discussion?
I have a question.
Question.
And I saw Tyler. Tyler, we saw that you requested the radio so many times, just praying we were just going to let it fly through.
Yeah, we
duplicated pages.
Just throw as much on the wall and see what sticks.
These radios that you're requesting for new position in SROs, a total of how many radios are there?
It's only, there's 12 total. The digital system that we're under, the radios are fairly expensive. And then five, are actually what they call dual band. That way they can talk to those on digital and those on the analog. And those are for our SROs.
So you have five for the SROs?
Yes. And my good friend, we really haven't gone into much detail, but my good friend and colleague, Mr. Woodward, I think we're going to have a meeting about the equipment. Yeah. No, so that it would be for them. I'm not sure. It hasn't really been announced, but we've been approved with the schools for four SRO positions through the grant.
Good.
And so we're trying to get equipment and everything for that as well.
So that, but those are for the new SROs?
Yeah, the one that the commission approved for us through our funding through the budget, and then the four for the grant funding that's coming available to us.
Yeah. Good job.
And what exactly are these lighting packages that you're requesting?
I'm sorry?
The lighting packages.
Lighting packages for Anderson County Sheriff's Office Drug Task Force?
Oh, yeah. That's just the like the car lights.
For the cars.
Yeah, because a lot of those guys are in, I wouldn't necessarily call what you say undercover, but a lot of times they will get traffic in the middle on Edgemoor like a wreck.
Right.
And they're driving big trucks with no lights, so it's more of a danger for them to not have lights.
Perfect.
But the good news is we will be, the task force just gave us a $10,000 check, so it'll cover more than what we're asking for there.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Any other questions?
Yes,
Mr. Bob.
Jail commissary.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, that's the current balance. It really can only be used for things at the jail. And actually, I'm going to be asking for a little bit more money. I don't see Jay here, but we just got approved by the comptroller on Friday that those funds can also be used for transportation vehicles for our prisoners. So that does help. So the 10,000 request was prior to that, so I would be asking at some point if you all could, if we could change that amount so we can buy some transportation vehicles. Lieutenant Val has some transport officers with cars that are exceeding 200,000 miles. The newest one, we could get you a good deal at probably 190,000 miles. And they're making a lot of long runs. So, new, yeah. So the jail commissary fund, we asked for an opinion from Jay, and so Jay reached out to the comptroller, and they did give our blessing to purchase. But it has to be for transportation at the jail for prisoners only. But that was just another avenue that we could go after to try to minimize capital outlay requests, et cetera.
And Tyler, when you say that you're transporting them, it's not just, as an example, from the jail to the courthouse.
No.
It's to go for
doctors. It's go mental health facilities, doctors to another facility, picking them up from another facility. You know, if we've got a prisoner that's in Davidson County, they satisfy their requirements, but there's a hold in Anderson, we might go pick them up there. There's just a slew of things that we areas that we transport to.
Any other questions?
None.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Need a motion to approve 19 and 20?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you.
Would y'all want to consider increasing the one from the commissary fund to 80,000?
What?
He would like to increase the jail commissary to $80,000 instead of 10 to buy the cars, or do you want to?
Where do you see that at?
I'd request that it be done separately.
Okay.
Because that is specifying that it's for the HVAC for the jail.
All right, we'll wait.
Detention facility.
We can
wait. What's the pleasure of the board?
How much do car cost, Tyler? How much do you need for a car?
So for the three, we've looked at Explorers, as you know. John Vicker, and the cost to upkeep the Chargers is astronomical. I don't remember what the part was, but there was like an $800 difference in having a Charger versus an Explorer. So we're looking at Explorers. The total cost with outfitting them all was a maximum of $70,000 for three. So they would be, we would, for these, we would go the Missouri route on these, which we're looking at newer vehicles on for patrol, but three Explorers, and you know, it'd be very minimal lights and just enough to where if they have to pull over, if there's a DUI, if there's a wreck or something, that they're visible out in the street.
Can we just add that? We can add it, no problem, and just add in the narrative that it's for HVAC and cars and do it all the day?
If that's your pleasure.
And again, I apologize. I just didn't have an opinion from the law director to get this in sooner. My apologies.
Okay. I was going to say, since we've got a law director and comptroller approval, and they've done got the prices on what they need, and it's not taxpayers' money, it's commissary funds that they're buying this with, I'm going to that we go ahead and increase the cost up to the $80,000 they need to cover the cost of obtaining these.
Good move.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you. Go get your cars.
All right. That's going to take us to number 23. from the law director. And actually, 23 is a budget amendment. It's an issue that was left out of the budget. Jay asked for or obtained a raise last year out of unassigned for two of his employees, and it wasn't put back in the budget for this year. So we're paying her at this rate, but we don't have the money budgeted. So I'm just asking that you all reapprove it so we can get it in the budget for this fiscal year.
Y'all have heard the discussion.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Got a motion and a second to approve. Discussion.
This doesn't, come on. This does affect the fund balance.
It does, but it should have already affected the fund balance anyway. It should have been included. When the budget committee reverted back to last year's budget, any amendment that passed that affected unassigned fund balance was included with that, and this one was left out. So that's why.
Any more discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
We may find other things like that as we go along that was inadvertently changed that shouldn't have been.
Well, we'll take baby steps and try to catch them all.
Well, we're correct.
I'm just saying, we may find more as we go along.
Absolutely.
That's true.
But every one of us know that we went through a pretty good agenda over the last 7 or 8 months. So anyway, go ahead, Mr. Robert.
Okay.
24?
Yes, it's an appropriation from the circuit court, Rex Lynch.
Let's let Rex explain this to us.
Yeah. All right, in your packet, you should have a letter from Melanie Davis, the juvenile court, as well as a letter from the company that used to do the maintenance on our, I call it the giant Rolodex for our files in juvenile court. So, and this had been brought up early in the budget cycle. I asked y'all to put that on the capital outlay because the equipment can't be serviced anymore. When it breaks, it's done. And like the letter from Melanie states, when it breaks, and I mean, basically court almost will shut down. So I went back and looked at the budget, went back to talk to Robbie.
Now Rex, tell us what you said when the equipment breaks. What equipment are you actually talking about?
It's the two, there's two, I forget the name of it, it's in the letter. Trevor 80s. They're 1980 machines. We bought them or got them used from the Department of Energy back early 2000s, so it was, they've had a good life.
1980s?
They were manufactured in 1980. They're 35 to 40 years old. So the machines have outlived their life. There is a maintenance, we've had a maintenance contract on them all these years. This year, the company that works on them says we can't work on them anymore, they're done.
Where's the money coming from, Ray?
So I went back and looked at the budget, worked with Robbie. There's two codes, the litigation tax and the general sessions court fines have significantly increased, and a lot of that's due to our increase in our collections. Our collections are up about 40, you know, low 40%. So the additional collections that we've been able to collect go into all these different codes, and these are two of the ones that are benefiting from that. So we can increase both litigation tax by $25,000 and the general sessions court fines by $5,000, and I think we've still got, that should be very safe compared to last year and what looks like it's coming in.
Motion to approve.
So you feel pretty confident with that?
I feel very confident with it.
Got a motion to approve.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Discussion.
I have a question.
Yes.
You've got an email from Melanie Davies explaining that it had been breaking down and the guy had been there, et cetera.
Yes.
That's August 26th. Attached to that is an email from January 16th.
It is.
Why didn't you bring this to us during budget?
I did. If you look at your capital outlay,
it's on the capital outlay list.
So we have an opportunity with some additional revenue that's came in that won't impact the fund balance. The timing is kind of critical. Found out from juvenile court, the letter will tell you when Judge Hunt is going to be out of town. So if we get this approved, it's a very tight timeline. That we can get, because we got to pull every file out of the office and store it, hoping store it in the courtroom while Judge Hunt's on his, he's got some travel or some training or something. And then we'll have, hopefully work with the sheriff's office, get inmates to help rip out the shelving. And then we'll have 3 days to get the new shelving installed, and then probably work on the weekend moving the files back into that room.
Okay, and as you heard the choir sing, they said you did, and I know you did, but what I'm asking is, why didn't you bring it to us during the budget process back in January to say, this is now broken, we're at a critical point, leaving it 8 months later, this is what the outcome would be?
And I did.
In other words, you had an opportunity, and I'm not being rude, crude, or socially unacceptable, but it's to say that there was the manpower at the time, and this could have been repaired months ago.
Well, I thought that's what I did. I actually came and I said, this piece of equipment is on its last leg. Please put it on your capital outlay list.
Right.
We're going to operate and we should get 6 months to 12 months out of it. So I've just kind of been waiting for the capital outlay process. But this money, I just found out this money's available.
Right.
We've got a time. Or I would still probably wait until y'all decide to fund some more capital.
Well, but they're at a point now where they're even stating that they can't access some of the files because of the breakdown of
it. No, they're not broke right now. They are at the point.
You've got to back up again.
Huh? I don't know what, I'd have to read the letter, but they've not broken, but the maintenance says, look, if you go down there, the maintenance company came in and says, we can't fix it anymore.
Right.
That's what, it says we can't fix it anymore. They repaired it that day, but there's a linkage and a chains or some gears or some bearings bushing. It's just the point, it's 40 years old.
How many files does this unit, is it holding?
Hundreds and hundreds of files.
Are there files in there that can be archived and or
that's exactly what
digitized?
We're going through the process now is pulling the ones that can be archived.
Okay.
Out of there.
Okay, good.
So what we've also done, y'all allowed us to purchase a filing system in Oak Ridge with the bid process.
Right.
It came down to $1.78 per linear file inch was the best bid we've got. Jay worked with a purchasing agent and with law director, we can extend that $1.78 per linear file inch to this project as well. And so I've got quotes in today. It's $29,200, but it's at the $1.78 per linear file inch.
Okay.
So the $30,000 will handle it?
It will.
Any more discussion? Mr. Bob.
Those were bid originally, though.
It was. Yeah, we sent out five different vendors. Two did not, but we got three different quotes in. And the ones, if you ever want to see the system, it's what's similar to. We've got them installed in Oak Ridge now, and we're starting to move some of our files that were at the jail. We're putting those in the files in Oak Ridge for our General Sessions 1 file. So it's very
impressive.
Any
more discussion? Need a motion?
Second.
Then I've got a motion and a second. All the discussion's over. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you. Mr. Cole.
Jeff also has a request increasing revenue and increasing his office supplies.
Move for approval 25 to 26.
Second. Got a motion and a second. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jeff.
Appreciate it. Okay, 27 through 30 are from the IT department. We can take them individually or as a group. I will say the first two, the 27 and 28, we're moving a lot of the communication money into one code to pay for all of our communication needs out of one code, which we actually, Brian had discussed this with Natalie last year, but with everything that happened, we never did get it done in the budget. So this is the first line of those moves that we're making to move all the communication money to one major code, the 58900 code. And Brian may want to speak more on that if you need for him to.
You got discussion for us or anything?
I'm ready for discussions.
Questions for Brian. Questions for Mr. Bob.
I didn't see how this impacts the budget.
This is money that's already put into the budget. We're just moving codes from one to the other, from out of the individual department codes into 307, if I'm saying that correctly.
Right, you are.
And that funds 307 going forward so that we pay all telephone expenditures from one code instead of breaking it down out of the departments and then back into the...
I do like to see on the bottom when it says how this impacts the budget. I like to see those.
This has no impact on the budget for next year or...
I know it has no impact, but that doesn't say that, does it?
Right, no, it doesn't. In fact, I don't even see that.
So it looks like one of them has...
He's creating new codes, yeah.
Well, the last one, the 27 and 28 has no impact. 29 impacts, well, I mean, it's out of unassigned fund balance.
Yep. $2,015.
But it won't have an impact next year because I think this is the last payment we have to make.
No, that's a contingent. The,
okay.
The $22,015, the $19,327.80 will be, and it's not exact, that's a reoccurring third and fourth quarter estimates for the renewals that will occur every year in third and fourth quarters for our telephone system that we bought in 2014. You had purchased into the package that you bought this funded through that five-year period. The five-year period has ended. Going forward with the phone system in order to keep the licensing and the appropriate warranties, et cetera, with our phone vendors, this is required yearly to maintain our equipment.
Did you say we've already paying for equipment annually?
I think there's one more probably now.
We owe one more payment on the BCTI for that, and then we have to start paying. These are fees for two.
Yeah, this is coming up for, this is 2019's third and fourth quarter. Coming up.
What are we paying annually right now?
As far as the...
We have one more payment on our loan that we borrowed the money for the BCTI equipment.
Well, I'm getting at, you know, this $22,000 won't be an annual thing because it'll be offset by what we're paying annually right
Pretty
now.
Pretty much, yes.
Yeah, there'll be some adjustment, I would think, in the final numbers when they get to the end of it, I would assume.
But 27 and 28 is not going to affect the budget in any way.
No, it won't.
Oh, then let me...
Let's just do them 27 and 28, then do...
Let me have a motion that we approve 27 and 28.
So motion to approve.
Got a motion. Need a second.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Any more discussion on 27 and 28? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Now number 29, the $22,015.03.
And actually, Brian talked to you guys about this last budget meeting, I think, and we deferred it because we have... But one of them is... The $19,000 is for the fees, and the $2,687 is for the switch and the EMS that was struck by lightning that BCTI is charging.
And that equipment that was struck by lightning, that's been replaced. You just wanted to put a new one back on the shelf.
Well, no, we have a temporary, a loaner from our vendors.
Okay.
The EMS running at this point. They are operating off of a loaner switch from our vendor. This is to purchase the replacement equipment. I have turned it into HR for a damaged equipment, and let the insurance do whatever they do with that. I do know that our deductible was $2,500, but they still counted this.
Right.
I think that comes off our deductible. But as it stands, we still have to replace that equipment.
Okay.
So I'm requesting on that, the second number on 29 to be, that's for EMS to replace it. But as we talked about in operations prior and then in commission, this all comes down to it's the phone system in its entirety. Should we put that on a department? Should we put that individual? It's the phone system. So they decided not to burden EMS, but to put it in out of 307, I think was our gist that day. So this is the continuation of that. I need to get a switch for Nathan's.
So we have no choice on either one of these.
Not really, you have to pay him.
You have to have a switch. You can't operate with any phones or computer. Yeah.
Well, don't get me wrong. My question was, the $22,000 wasn't going to be a continuing thing since we're already paying. There's going to be some offset.
Yeah, there'll be offsets.
There's not going to be a new expense because you're going to be, if we've got one more payment, when that payment's done, that's going to be, drop this amount right here down.
Next year, for third and fourth quarter, I'm very interested to see what it actually triggers.
Yeah, there'll be an adjustment.
Right.
I need a motion on number 29, please.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
I got a motion to approve number 29. Second. I got a second. Any more discussion?
Yes,
Mr. Bob.
Did I understand this to say this comes out of fund balance though for 29?
For 29, that would be out of fund balance out of 307. I know that, right? That would be 307 fund balance. Yes, sir.
Is this something we didn't know about during the budget process?
We were just kind of learning about it. It wasn't put in, but this is something we can put in the budget from now on.
The director or operator manager or whatever from BCTI reached out to me and explained to me about a month ago, a month and a half, that this was something that we need to plan for going forward. She wanted us to inform the legislature here to find out how we proceed. I had the same questions, how do I proceed? So that's why I'm here, as to how we proceed with that expense. It was, I don't know if bonded's the correct word in the past, but that ends. So we do have to have a mechanism to keep that equipment up to date with our vendor, Cisco. Cisco is the equipment that we run in the county, and Cisco requires those updates and things to be on their equipment up to date.
Mr. Vowell.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Brian, I just want to make sure that I'm right. This is just the 307 code that we're talking about?
Not on these.
Not on the second line, right? Would the first line be 307?
Yes.
I think the first line should be 307. It's to pay for the phone system.
Right.
But then I think that comes into how does 307 get funded in the long run?
It really shouldn't be. 307 is a communication code, so in my opinion, this shouldn't be 307, but more like.
Are you saying it shouldn't be?
Not for the switch that was struck by lightning.
Yeah, I agree with that.
I don't think it should be 307 at all, no. Sorry, I just noticed that.
But then what should it be?
Other supplies and materials, $499.
So I switched to 307 for the switch to $499.
I think so.
Any more discussion?
Let's let it go.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Okay, and the last one from Brian is $1,000 from unassigned fund balance and increasing his staff development code for $1,000. He's sending one of his employees to UT for a grant writing class.
Second.
Motion and a second. Discussion? All in favor say?
Just a quick question.
Quick question.
Brian, since you're there, how will the county benefit from this?
Currently, as part of her training, Tammy, we've been asked to pick.
Brian, move over there. Thank you.
We've been asked to pick a grant to proceed with, and where we're standing right now, I have one in mind that I would like to do down the road, but the one we've chosen to go with at this point will affect the schools and get them for their security. Tammy can probably tell you a little bit on it too, but what it comes down to is like magnetrons, video surveillance. There's quite a few grants for the school systems for that type of equipment due to the school shootings and the problems with that. There's grants out in the industry for that. So we're going to try to attempt to pull those. We're working with, Tammy's reaching out to Wade. This is all currently happening now. So we're trying to lay that process out, how we will benefit the county. The one we have now will probably more than likely benefit the schools, IT.
Well, that's still part of the county.
Correct.
How much money can we look to possibly save from this grant?
On the numbers, Tammy, I'm going to have to refer on you.
It should be thousands.
We're literally in the last 48 hours working this, so it's very new to us what we're doing with this project. The Microsoft TechSoup side of it, it's a group that works with grantors. That's something that I can see $40,000 to $50,000 worth
Good.
Of savings in a year on some of our office purchases for Microsoft Office packages. Those things are almost $300 each. I'm looking at having to purchase Windows 10 due to it. Windows 7 ends at the end of this fiscal year or
right.
period as far as calendar year. We're looking at purchases there. Some of these things I would like to try to use these grants that exist to cover some of this expense for our software.
Beautiful.
And as time marches on, I mean, there's programs for drones, there's all types of different systems out there for IT that I would like to fundamentally take the time to explore them. I've got a little time with Tammy to devote to this, and so I'm taking that time from her regular daily duties to see if we can pull in some of these funds.
Excellent.
I think we can.
Excellent. Thank you.
Thank you.
Any more discussion? Do I have a motion?
Yes.
I've got a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you, Brian.
That's your request.
That's mine too.
Good.
All right.
Mark Stevens.
Yes, and he's not here, but he's increasing his data processing equipment $1,764.68, increasing his revenue by the same amount. He's actually, it's a request for a new state computer and monitor and printer, and the state's going to, once we pay for it, they're going to reimburse us for that.
Move.
Got a motion and a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you.
Okay. Next, we have 32 through 34 from Brian Porter in Animal Control, increasing the 101-551-207-32, that's the cat dormitory project, and decreasing his reserve by that amount. Actually, all of them are decreasing the reserve and increasing other contracted services by $10,000. And the next one's other, he could have put them all in one, but he did three different ones.
And the money's coming from where?
The reserve for the animal, restricted for public health and welfare, animal holding, it's got $43,604 in it.
Motion to approve.
Got a motion? Need a second?
Second.
Got a motion and a second, discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries.
Okay, the next one is from the mayor, and it's increasing contributions to other agencies, 101-585-316, and decreasing committed reserve for other purposes, industrial land purchases, by $25,000. That fund has, or that reserve has $340,000 in it.
Motion to approve.
Got a motion?
Second.
Got a motion and a second, discussion?
Yep.
Mr. Bob.
Where are we proposing to increase broadband in the county? Where specifically?
Good question.
Commissioner Smallridge, this is for the north end of the county, so this would expand broadband out to the marina area. So actually we have someone from Sequoia Marina here tonight that's also making an investment. The other added benefit would be that this business line that would be going in would also expand broadband to a lot of folks in the residential area that have been wanting broadband for a very long time. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of a win-win. We're doing it for economic development and tourism reasons, but yet the citizens will benefit as well.
Good deal.
Good.
Thank you.
Shane.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mayor, I'm going to ask you a question you may not know the answer to. And it's fine if you don't, but I've been asked this by some of mine and Commissioner Isabel's constituents. Good Lord willing, this goes into effect. What kind of cost are we talking for the customers? If you know.
I do not know.
Okay.
I do not know. I do know in your particular district, I've been in talks with Highland Communications mm-hmm. about getting something going there. There's actually an ARC opportunity for $1.3 million in broadband that we're talking about hopefully doing something in your district. We've been working on it a very long time, yeah. And it's just, it's very hard. It's very hard, but I think things are finally moving, so.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Any more discussion? Any more discussion? Need a motion?
Got one and a second.
Do you have a motion and a second?
Let's vote then. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? I get carried away in this discussion that I forget where we're at. I'm sorry. Motion carries.
All right. The next budget amendment is from Stephanie Wells in Tourism. It's increasing 101-512-407-91 TRGR. Tourism Enhancement Grant, $71,151.05. And it's decreasing a committed reserve, 44901, a restricted, 25,000, and it's asking for $1,250 from unassigned fund balance to complete the project.
Do I have a motion?
Motion to approve.
Got a motion to approve. Second?
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Discussion? Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you.
Okay, and the next two are from finance. The first one's from Randy Walters, who handles our grants. It's increasing the ASAP budget $100,000 and it's decreasing unassigned fund balance by $100,000. And I know you guys are wondering, we're not taking money from unassigned. Actually, what happened is we increased revenue in the budget for the ASAP, $100,000, but we didn't put $100,000 in an expenditure code. So we're taking it. So that money rolled into unassigned. So we're asking for it from unassigned to put into the expenditure code. It adds to the expense code omission. I know that's really hard to understand. Me and Randy have had this explained to us three different times.
It's a lot of zeros.
Well, and honestly, last year they had $100,000 and they never used a penny of it. So it's a washout when it happens. And whatever they use, it's a reimbursable grant.
It's rolling back over. Right. Okay. I'm good with that, then.
Everybody understand? I need a motion.
I'm not sure I do.
Ask me a lot of questions.
Motion to approve.
I got a motion to approve. I got a motion and a second. Discussion.
Yeah, I guess I'd like a little more explanation.
Well, this is what I can explain it better. So we increased revenue $100,000, but we didn't put the expense for $100,000 on there. So really, if we had done that, our budget would have been $100,000 more. Instead of 473, it would have been $573,000 in the red because of this. But it was left off. Does that make it better sense?
Is it a permanent reduction in fund balance?
It's already there.
Yes, it'll be a washout. So when they spend any money, it's reimbursed by the state. We don't really actually even have this money yet. Right, Randy?
Okay. So it's on its way.
When we spend it, we'll get it.
We haven't spent anything yet. The issue is Robbie saying is when the budget was first prepared, for whatever reason, only the revenue got recorded. There was no corresponding expense recorded in the budget for it. Because of that, the revenue was budgeted and that affected the fund balance. This is just true as a fact.
But this reduces the fund balance to a certain extent.
It does.
Any other discussion? You satisfied, Mr. Bobby?
Yeah, I think so.
Any more discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you.
Okay, and the last one is we're increasing, the BOCA grant is growing this year. We're increasing the revenue code, sorry, $67,795. We're decreasing two codes in BOCA, 307 and 599, 118 and 250. And then we're increasing all the codes below. And we're actually giving money back. Are we giving money back to unassigned there?
Tell me where you're at. I've lost you.
Page 58.
That one.
Page 58?
Yes, I'm
okay,
I'm
sorry.
Good. Yeah, thanks.
It's a grant from the state, so we're not. It's none of the county funds.
Motion to approve.
Got a motion? I got a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you.
And if possible, could I would like to ask if we could, if I could submit one more budget amendment from the highway department.
Pleasure of the board. Bring it on.
Okay. Apparently, Mr. Long needs some more asphalt.
So he's going to fill potholes. That's a lot of potholes.
He's asking to increase his asphalt code and by $300,000 and decrease his restricted for highways $300,000, and he has more than $3 million in
motion to approve.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you, Rob.
Yes, sir.
Actually,
that's all that I have on my portion. The rest of the items on the budget committee agenda are for other people. So the first two are for Jay, and I'm hoping he's out in the hall. And I'm gonna go check real quick.
So we'll just move those down and
Tim Isabel.
Tim.
Which one is that?
I can explain the tips.
B?
Sir?
I can explain the tips, but let Tim go first. In Jay's absence.
Oh, okay, okay.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of Operations Committee, our Budget Committee. I thought it was going to flip. What we're here for today is that we have been graciously given a grant to get air tanks, and we're asking for a match on that. And as everybody here knows, that our rural fire departments are very important to our communities and to this county. And we talked about this earlier about, you know, trying to do something, because air packs are very important. And they're dated, and it's astronomical cost now. And we have a grant, and if you want to come up, Chief.
We got three quotes on air packs. The Scott air packs was over $80,000. MSA's was 60 plus, and we found a company that will sell them to us for 52, and they're a well-known brand. A lot of the city of Rocky Top and other city, Bryceville and all of them's done went to them. So this is something that if we had the funds, we wouldn't be asking, but between this time last year and this year, we've raised, on fundraisers, $26,880. The engines have bought us. We're afraid to put hose and stuff, buy the hose and stuff for it, in case we do have to match this grant, because we have to have the air packs to perform our duties.
Question, and they're,
yes.
Yes.
Is this a company that you're comfortable with, sir?
Yes.
It is?
Yes.
Okay. Just because of the price, that's, well, not the deciding factor?
They've probably been longer, building in it longer than MSA.
Okay. Thank you. That was my question. I just wanted to make sure this was a reputable company that you were comfortable with.
How many air packs are you looking at?
12.
And these are for Medford?
Yes.
Okay.
12 for Medford. Mr. Merritt.
Yes. So you got a grant for 31 and you're borrowing 25, is that what I understand?
Yes.
From USDA, it's probably 0% or less than,
well,
that.
If we can't get it matched, we will have to borrow.
Gotcha.
And it'll be at a 3-something percent.
Gotcha.
How much do you need?
$25,000.
It's for our firefighters.
Oh, are you approved?
Second.
Any discussion?
Keeps them off the streets, off the corners.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you want to go ahead, Rick, and do this?
I'll do mine at the end.
Okay, sure. Okay. So next on the agenda is Kim Jeffers Whitaker with the security badge access system.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
I think you all received part of, in your bid package, the score sheet as well as the pricing that was received on the RFP for updating the systems. We also had those broken down by buildings. The update is for the courthouse, and the remainder of them are pretty much new systems. The one that, Brian's still here, okay. The one that was chosen by those who scored was Central Technologies. It is $110,689.50. That is a fluid amount, meaning that's what we think it's going to cost. But there is a chance when we get into this that it may not be as much, or it may cost a little more. Brian, you want to help speak to that? Just so you're aware, too, juvenile court, if I'm not mistaken, is still down. They do not have a security system right at the moment because Gallagher, the system has went down. I think Brian has checked on it. So we're kind of needing some of that addressed.
How long has it been down?
A week.
A week.
Completely down for a week, but it's been partially functional for a couple months.
They're
their badge engine, the database and the server system that ran it was a very old system that I inherited. The basically, they had installed this on a workstation in that department. The Galahar Security or whoever in the past had decided to set it up in Melanie's department, and Melanie inherited it as well. And I know Angie suffered with it prior to Melanie. I had a programmer come in to try to save the database. Galahar wants 160 per hour to look at it. We had them look at other issues we've had in the past with the old badge system. I guess the best words is I don't trust it. I think what I would like to see happen as far as with them, they have no recourse at this moment, at Melanie Davies.
Ms. Scott.
Thank you. If we were to approve this, how quickly could you get that fixed?
I know they want it first. The Central Knox will be the vendor installing. That's who won the bid, correct? I mean, I can push. I've already talked to Melanie about it. I mean, we can get them to start first, but it'll take, you know, at least a few, you know, a couple of weeks to get this system, at least.
I would say at least.
And then what do you do in the meantime?
We have keys. We've got some keys.
The monthly amount, Kim, the $1,387, how long does that go for? Is it a one-year contract or?
Catherine, do you want to speak to the contract part of it? I don't believe I'd, maybe.
In other words, is that amount likely to go up in 6 months or 2 years?
It's going to be good for at least a year.
At least a year.
Yes. The system that is in the juvenile court is the same that's in the courthouse. Now, obviously, the goal would be to start at the locations that's broken, and also with the Jolly Building that doesn't have one in several areas. And the courthouse would probably be last because there's already a system in place. And the goal, of course, with this too, is in while we start updating and moving the systems, that's when it would start easing over to the sheriff's department a little piece at a time, where they would have that.
Well, I think this is a no-brainer.
Yeah.
And Robbie can speak to where the money can come from.
Uh-oh. That'd be a good idea.
We're all sitting down.
Well, we do have a courthouse security restricted fund that has quite a bit of money in it. And I have prepared a budget amendment that we could move that money from
and
there.
And we could take it from that fund, right?
We could. I do want...
You sound reluctant. You
well, I'm only reluctant because, and I'm not reluctant at all, but apparently ESG is coming, is it to speak to operations tonight? The mayor had spoke to, they make it even do this theirself with the savings. I mean, that would probably be a lot longer of a project. I don't know.
Well, I do have ESG, and you could still deal with juveniles issue, which is an immediate issue. And you might just ask ESG. They just did a complete overhaul for the schools. The sheriff did meet with ESG, and I think they're willing, they can speak to that. Their folks are here. They're willing to look at that as an option as well. If we can get it paid for out of savings instead of writing a check for $100,000, that to me would seem like a no-brainer. But I still, obviously, these folks need something in the interim, and maybe you authorize that repair or something, just to ask ESG tonight if they could even look at that. Yeah. So,
okay, thank you, Robbie. What kind of motion you need? Oh, I'm sorry. Wait a minute.
I'm thanking Mr. Chairman. I was just
Mr. Mayor.
Going along with the mayor's idea, but I think maybe one of them may need to answer what kind of repairs would get them by until we had a final answer.
It cost $160 an hour to bring Galahar over here to just look at it, and then you have to pay for fuel as well, and I don't remember the charge on fuel.
Brian, is it even repairable?
It's not. The equipment running the doors is okay. The problem is the database that everybody's names and badges and systems are in is corrupted.
Didn't I understand somebody a few minutes ago say you didn't trust or didn't?
I think the better words I'd prefer not to use, if you remember a couple of years back, that same vendors who we still are using.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, pull that.
So that was in 2006 when we purchased it, and this system as well as that system has not been updated. No software updates, nothing has been done, and Brian has had to put the systems, I don't know how to say it, Brian, on their own system so it doesn't touch anything else for fear of what might occur.
Okay, so what kind of motion do you need?
I have a quick question to throw this out there.
Okay.
I do too.
I'm sorry, which one is going
first? Scott, yes.
So
yes.
Robbie, they're asking for the Jolly building itself, it's $35,845. So this is for Robbie and the mayor. Mm-hmm. Can we not take those funds out of the security code and allow them to get off of what they're on and put them on a new system by taking that money out there, and to go to ESG and say, we're in the process of doing this because it was a fire that needed to be put out?
Sure, I think so. Well, I mean, what gives me anxiety is when we say it could be this amount or it could be this amount.
Sure.
And when I get a quote or a bid, I want to know what it's going to cost. And I think investing $160 an hour for someone to come and see, can it get all, I mean, I think that's worth an investment instead of just saying, let's do $100,000 when we might have an opportunity to pay for it out of savings. So, but yes, that could be done as well. I mean, I'm not the person to ask. I didn't even realize this was on the agenda until I got Kim's email. Russ will be here at operations. I know you're gonna be here at operations. These are, I mean, he just did all of the schools. They do work for the Pentagon. I'm sure they know security. So, you know, it could be something you ask them. What do they think? Is it something to look at? And what would they recommend in the short term? So.
Well, to get this off center.
Sure.
I mean, we want the Jolly building
to be secure.
We want it done.
Well, the Jolly building has not been secure. They're talking about their own juvenile court access, which is a smaller piece of the larger pie. The
Jolly, maybe that's what I was saying, juvenile court. But we want that done.
Yeah.
Am I not right?
Yeah.
Since they're meeting tonight, I need to make a decision a couple of hours before. Can we just send this to full commission without a recommendation and take it up then?
If that's
that way we'll know exactly what's going on with this.
Or you could just approve like $3,000 out of that code and have somebody come out and look at it.
Would that work?
Or we could change it.
I just don't want to make a decision right now when we've got people coming tonight.
We don't want
to put more to it, and we may get a better deal if we're doing everything, and they may have something.
We'll make it a motion. Let's vote on it.
Okay. I make a motion we send this to full commission without a recommendation.
I got a motion. Send it to full commission without a recommendation. Second?
Second.
I got a motion and a second. Discussion?
Just at some point, I wanted to ask a question about the...
Ask it right now.
Okay. We're recommending, or at least video services was a low bidder, am I right, by about
$10,000?
I'm
sorry.
This right here.
$3,000.
Video.
Yes.
Yes. And then if you look at the service agreement, there's a significant difference there,
so
too.
So the service agreement was apples to oranges. They weren't comparable. So the service agreement that we requested to be bid was only specific to Central Technologies. The rest of them did not bid fully what we requested.
Okay. Well, I was looking at the fact that...
Yes.
That was only for up to two trips, up to 8 hours.
Okay, so they weren't comparable.
Yes.
We asked for unlimited.
the evaluation, I guess. Who actually did the evaluation?
So HR, IT, Sheriff's Office. So we took all the people that are currently manning the security system, which is HR, IT, who has that side of information and where it is going to, and who has security background, which is the Sheriff's Office.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Any more discussion? Got a motion on the floor that... Oh, Mr. Isabel, sorry.
Thank you again, Mr. Chairman. This same subject's coming up on operations as well. You know, I think they got touch with Commissioner Val and myself. So we're trying to attack this in both directions because they're very vulnerable right now because they actually can't get into the rooms quick enough. I mean, if there's somebody in, and I don't want to go into too much detail because it's going to tell how vulnerable they are, but it is a dire situation that we do something as soon as possible because being able to get into that room, it may take a minute to actually get the door open and get in because of the keys that they have to use. So I mean, it's a pretty dire situation. So whatever you do, we'll follow suit from operations. But I just, it is on operations committee as well.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
We got a motion on the floor that we send this to full commission without a recommendation. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? No. Motion carries.
Okay, well, next up is Kim again with the compensation plan update.
So I sent you all an email that had the information. It wasn't in your packet. If you didn't print that, I have copies. Would you all like me to hand those out?
A copy, please. Okay.
Thank you. Here's another. So we've been talking about this for a bit. What you're looking at tonight is in regards to the recommendation, which you can find on page one with the charts on page two. That's on the classification updates. So currently we have classifications that maybe do not accurately describe the work that's being done. And so with doing this process, I've requested that the department heads share the job descriptions as well as the titles that they have tied to those employees. So some of this in the top portion on page two is the proposed class title. It's simply changing the titles from what is listed on our compensation plan now to what they are being called or determined by, whether it's CTAS or the department head. Exhibit 5B has the proposed classification additions. These are for departments who may have had new employees added, and as you know, we've had a new department added with IT. So we had to go through and do that classification. On page one, you can see the target peers that were utilized in developing where those classifications hit and the proposed levels. All of those were discussed with each department. Anybody have any questions on those?
Questions?
Yes,
Ms. Scott.
So your peer data collected.
Yes.
You've got Blount County, Knox County, Fentress County, Rutherford County. Why those specific counties?
So I asked several counties, but these are the ones that shared their information, their data. I also asked for City of Clinton, City of Oak Ridge. They both shared. So whenever we've done the peer review, though, as far as looking at the ranges of pay in conjunction with population and your elected officials, your Blount County and the City of Oak Ridge were the ones that were most comparable to Anderson County as far as ranges. Oak Ridge City, we utilized a lot for classification information. You know, not everybody has parks and such. So to have something to review those with.
Any other questions? So what are we to do with this?
So what I was asking for is on page two, the exhibit 5A and 5B, that you all allow me to update those and add those to our compensation plan.
Pleasure of the board.
Kim, what's the proposed level? What is that? Is that going to be in determining their pay?
Correct. And those are also utilized, and most of those, to be quite blunt with you, most of those are already in that pay level. That's where they're at.
But I guess I wouldn't be comfortable with approving any pay levels on levels until I could see what that level
is. So if you look on the last page, it's the rationale of utilizing, whether it's on a pay level or the decision. I'm sorry, it's not the last page because the sheriff's office pay salary is at the back of that. It's on page four. It looks like this. I think yours is in color. Mine's in black and white. That is the rationale for developing each one of these, for adding those and where they fit on the pay level.
But there's no pay listed.
No, the pay that they're already making are on these levels that's being suggested.
Okay. So no one's getting a big pay increase?
Well, no, we're not to that part yet. No, this is just on classification.
Yeah, but that's coming, so that's why I'm asking.
Yes,
because if we set the proposed level and then somebody decides that, for instance, level eight is, you know, $10,000 above what they're making right now, then yes. Then we've already determined the pay level.
So
it also gives me a little apprehension because, for example, Rex, I'll pick on him because he's sitting here, but if he decides what his clerk makes,
correct,
his clerks make, and he's got to balance his budget, he's responsible for that. So if I come in here and I say, well, I think your clerks are to make $1,000 more than what you're paying them, he's got to find that to come up to pay.
Yes, but what I want you to know as well is that I've sat down with each elected official and department head in developing this. So, and what they're making and what's on this list is already where they're at. We already employ these people. It's not that they're not here. They're already here. They're already making these amounts of money. We just don't have them on our compensation plan and we don't have them classified. That's all this is. They're already there.
Mr. Chubb.
But coming to an election, that's, since he used Rex once before, I'll use Rex again. If Rex is, Rex said he's not going to run next time, mm-hmm. We have a new clerk come in, mm-hmm. And he rearranges his office. Mm-hmm. He puts this person in this position and this at the other. Then he may shift the balance in his office again, and this person may be making this, and he might next time not be making this. So you're going to have total shift, and then depending on who's elected, they may have different responsibilities, different pay, different things. So you're going to have, in the fee offices, you may have different things constantly changing depending on how the elections go.
So currently we only have in our pay schedule listing clerk one, clerk two, clerk three. But as you know, they're not all called clerk one, clerk two, clerk three, but that's where their levels hit in the compensation plan that was approved back in 2008 by the legislative body. So they're already there. It's, you know, where Rex decides where to title his employees based upon the job description is Rex. I'm sorry, Rex, now I'm picking on you. That's Rex's choice, you're right. And that's something that he works out in his own budget. This doesn't determine, these classifications don't determine what Rex does. This is updating something that was passed by this legislative body in 2008 to actually match and look like what we currently have in place.
Hey Kim, let me remind you, when we passed that in 2008, we never did fund it. We never did keep up with it.
Several of your department heads and elected officials do go by that compensation plan.
Okay, good.
Yes.
Good.
But at the same time, you've got some department heads that, because they're a department head, they're making X amount of dollars, whether they're certified or not, to do that job.
I have an issue with that. That's just giving somebody a different title and putting them in a classification because of that title, not because of what they're actually qualified, certified, or have the degree to do.
Okay. Ms. Denberg.
Don't these classifications come with qualifications?
Yes, they all have job descriptions that they are tied to, and a job analysis was done on each one of those in comparison to the CTAS. So that's where their bases are.
So it's not just a title, but there all are qualifications that go along with the actual specification.
And like I said, many of these have already been in place and been there for a while. IT was the biggest one that we built. So I had to sit down with Brian, and we had to do a lot of work, sit with Tammy, building their job descriptions based upon the analysis, based upon what CTAS recommended. So all of those went through that process. That's why it's taken us this long to get here. It just wasn't pulled out of one of the other peer reviews. They were simple. That wasn't how those were done. We went through them step by step with each department head.
Thank you. I think you've done a great job.
Any more statements, Mr. Bob?
Maybe because I'm fairly new, but I'd like to see. This has a lot of impact on our budget, on Anderson County, as well as our employees. You know, if as we move down the line with that recommendation. I'd like to see a meeting or a good portion of a meeting devoted to a more thorough discussion of this whole issue. And again, this may be because I'm fairly new, but I think it's very, very important what we end up with here.
Any more discussion? What Kim is wanting, what the HR director is wanting, is us for to approve Exhibit 5B, to add this to her.
It's 5A and 5B.
5A and 5B.
To update the classification titles to what the department heads and elected officials are actually utilizing. That's simply what we've got in our compensation plan is on the left-hand side, and what they're actually titling their employees is on the right.
On page 2, I'm sorry. This is what she's asking. I need a motion.
Motion to approve, Mr. Chairman.
Got a motion to approve. I need a second.
Second.
Got a motion and a second to approve Exhibit 5A and 5B on page number 2. Discussion.
Mr. Smallridge said, I'd just like some more time to talk about this and get a better understanding of it. I'm really just not comfortable with approving proposed levels without seeing a number beside it, and I don't want people picking and choosing who gets what title and the money that goes along with it. So I'm not saying I'm a no. I'm just saying I'd like to be a little bit more informed about it before I vote on it.
Okay, well, Denver, I've got a motion on the floor, so let's vote it up or vote it down.
I understand. I was just sharing my.
I understand. Any more sharing?
My opinion.
Any more sharing, Ms. Denver?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. It's my understanding that if someone does want to change a classification, I'm just going back to my days in corporate America, that it wasn't just one somebody that had that ability to do. If there had to have been reasons for them being moved up in classification based on additional responsibilities or education or that sort of thing. It's just not an arbitrary assignment.
Correct. And the current plan allows for that change. The current compensation plan speaks to, if you want to make a change in classification, you as a department head of the steps that you can go through, and it eventually has to come back to the legislative body to do so. It has to go through the steps to do that. You can't just make that change on your own, and I'll pick on Rex again. He went all the way through to commission and getting an additional duties added to some of his staff. That's the type of process that you go through. It just doesn't happen. You have to go through those steps to allow that to happen in a government setting.
Okay.
Thank you.
Any other discussion? Mr. Rick? Oh.
No, go ahead.
Mr. Chairman of the committee, to Denver's point, you're correct. But at the same time, it's up to this committee to fund it, as well as full commission, regardless of what we're seeing here. I think she's just trying to get a better idea of classifications. to fund it. And this, it would come back before this and full commission, is the way I would understand it. It would be up to us to fund it either way.
Either way.
It would also be my goal to take it in steps. That's why just bringing it to this point is the first step. We've not even talked about salaries and getting to, you know, we talked about disparity issues. I mean, if you want to talk about that, I can do that tonight, but I'd prefer not to. I feel like before I can really look at that, I need to know where the classification of the new employees that are not on our compensation plan are at.
Okay. Mayor, if you'll come up and tell us what you want to tell us, we'll vote either way.
I would just like an opportunity to see what's being proposed, and then, you know, if you all go ahead and approve it, that's fine, but I would like it to go to the HR committee and then some of the elected officials and departments be able to agree or disagree or provide input to Dr. Smallridge's point, you know, what we might have to say about it.
Okay. Thank you, Mayor. So, Kim, tell me, how time-sensitive is this?
However long y'all want to take. I'm just here to do what you want
me
to do.
That's not an answer. All right, we got to go ahead, Mr.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. To the mayor's point and others' points, maybe we let it go to HR and then come back here so they can define this. And if that way we don't have to approve it and it goes back to them, we come back, it'll prove it. We'd have to prove it again.
I'm fine with that, but.
Well, we got a motion on the floor.
I'll withdraw my motion then.
I would like to defer this. I would like to defer this item and proposal to the HR committee.
Second.
Okay. So the motion is withdrawn, and the second. Who? I thought you made the motion.
That's what I thought.
Yeah. Here's the motion right here.
No motion to defer though.
The ball is in Shane's.
Motion to defer is all right. That's fine.
The motion is in Shane's court right here. So you going to withdraw your motion?
Yes, sir.
And the second. Whoever seconded.
Oh, I didn't second.
No. All right, that's withdrawn. The motion to defer and the second. Any discussion on that? You're going to send it to the HR department?
Committee.
Committee. HR committee. And the mayor, you're on the committee?
Yes, sir.
Who all's on that committee?
All elected officials.
Except
for the commission. All elected officials.
Okay, good.
Department heads.
All right. Any discussion on that? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. It's on its way to HR committee. What's next, Mr. Robbie?
Well, I think I have next. I've lost my budget agenda. Did you take it?
I did.
There it went. The IT department savings points, Brian Young, was referred to from last budget meeting to this one.
Okay, I have, I guess over the last, I'm coming up on my third year here, October 31st, Halloween Day of 2016. Boo, that's when I showed up here at the courthouse as far as an employee of the County of Anderson. Prior to that, I think it was late May, I started as a contractor with the county. I went from May until October working with Natalie and the commission and the elected officials to rebuild the system after the badge issue that occurred. I have been, when I first got here, I started with pretty much about five departments that would, I don't want to use allow, but were willing to work with us. As time marched on, I went from trying to get people to work with me to now I have to try to find time to take restroom breaks, and that's after hours as well. I have to manage my life, my personal life, as well as, I mean, we all do that, but this job demands extreme amounts of time from me personally. I basically from daylight till AM, I keep my eyes on this place in the evenings, in the mornings. Vacation, sick, after surgery, it doesn't matter. I'm in the system checking it. Somebody's texting, somebody's calling. I've been accustomed to this through my life, that I gave up on having a life because this job consumes it. But as a result of that, I have taken on more and more and more and more, until the point that basically I'm running the entire county's IT infrastructure minus a couple of departments. I'm running everything as far as technical goes, the Wi-Fis, the server systems, the data systems, if you go down the sheet. And on top of that, I have brought what I would consider a pretty large savings to the county. I know when I first got here, we were paying out $21,000 a month to our phone and telephone vendors, our internet vendors, our vendors that supported the telephone system in its entirety. We were running plans that hadn't been changed in 30 years. We had systems in place that weren't touched due to department heads come and go, people change. Nobody wanted to dig into that GOM that I found on our phone system in particular. But basically, I've straightened out a lot of things. I've corrected a lot of things. I would like to keep doing that. But I'm also asking for a little bit of assistance on some of the time that I'm investing in this personally. And I don't know what you call that. If I don't want to label it raises or compensations or tie, I don't know what this is, but I'm doing a lot of work and being paid as what I would pay one of my key men prior to being here. So I just want to get into a situation, and I'm asking for direction. I'm a new department. I am the newest department in this county. And I have come here, and what we went through with this budget process, everyone was stripped and had things taken off because we had to achieve that goal. But at the same time, as a new department, when you're growing a department and building an infrastructure and trying to lay it out and perform it and make it work, to have things go backwards on you, that's kind of hard to compensate for on top of the extra workload. So
tell me what you're asking for.
I'm coming for you all that I would like some compensation for the extra work that I'm doing perpetually.
Okay.
And I started on this back in February before the budget process started. I know this is not the time or the place, but I'm at a place where I have to have help. I came into this county as a...
you want us to discuss this in front of you, or you want to go
out? I don't mind either way. I don't mind either way. I want to get to a better place.
Well,
I got a question. How many people have you added to your department? I mean, you're talking about the extra workload, but we've added people to your department.
I put
right?
Tammy to assist me with the administrative, the paperwork, all of the budget things that I have to do that are just common paperwork items. And then David Day, I brought him in originally after 6 months. We let Robert go. He was my helping on the smaller issues. As far as departments go across the state, other counties, for instance, Blount, they're larger departments than us, but we're, you know, of the same comparison. Knox County, you know, you can't even compare them. They have lots of IT.
Right.
So
how many people are in your office, including yourself?
Three.
Three.
Okay. Me and David and Tammy.
Including you three.
Yes.
Because, I mean, honestly, that's why you were brought in here. You keep saying save this, save that. That was your job here. I mean, yeah. And we're very happy. I am.
Well, the phone
very
work.
Happy that you did that. But that's why we wanted somebody in here.
Yes.
I don't know what your pay is, but I wouldn't be comfortable setting your pay. I think again, that should be something that the HR and everybody else to be comparable with everybody else in the county.
You don't have a comparable IT department to compare
well,
to.
Well, I understand, but with other department heads, okay, with people, I wouldn't want to sit here. I don't know what it is, but I wouldn't be comfortable setting your pay not knowing what other department heads are making. You can understand what I'm saying?
I agree. Go ahead.
Okay.
I was concerned, if I may, I was concerned when you took over the telephone system. I knew you were I'm not going to say you was overworked, but you was loaded before you took over that. And as Denver was saying, that's what we expected the IT guy to do, was to get our fat out of the fire.
Yes.
And you did that, and you took over the telephone system, and we never, this budget committee, or I don't think the mayor, I don't think anybody ever offered you any kind of pay because you took over the telephone system.
There's been nothing since the day I started.
And that is what I think the county is lacking. I think we ask you to do something that none of the rest of us could do. As Denver was saying, there's nobody else here in the courthouse that could do what you're doing there. Mayor, could I ask you to help me on this?
Well, Mr. Chairman, I did talk to Robbie about this because the phones have traditionally been handled out of the finance office. And so I did talk to him about perhaps getting with the IT advisory committee and modifying the job description. And then from the phone, from the finance office, perhaps doing that supplement. And Robbie did actually prepare a budget amendment to that effect, if that is what you would like to do. And he has that if you want him to hand that out. That would be a way to do that. And then if those job duties ever went away or someone else took on that role, then that supplement would go away.
Let me ask you, Mayor.
Yes, sir.
If we didn't have Brian to take care of the telephone system, would you have to hire somebody? Would you, how would that work if Brian wasn't doing that?
Well, in the past, it's been multiple individuals have done it. So in the past, it was actually, you can go back years ago, before I was here, you actually had a whole phone system budget. And what was that called, Robbie?
It was general administration. We paid Joyce McCulley to, you know, she manned the phone booth downstairs and made
a
full-time employee that manned the phone booth downstairs, and
okay.
We paid her probably $25,000 to $30,000. So we had, and we had two part-time, which we still have one part-time employee that
so
works.
The person that mans the phone in the hallway down there takes, has always
no, not anymore, no. Our office, the finance office, pays all the phone bills now, as Karen does in our office.
Okay. Ms. Scott.
You're talking about a phone system and how much it was costing us for telephones. He's doing more, far more than a phone system. He's manning all of these computers for the departments. I mean, it goes way back to when we had that breach. He was the guy that rescued us, came in and started tweaking and fixing and running new lines. And we have Wi-Fi in here. We have televisions. We have, I mean, all these new and updated things as a result of Brian.
Thank you.
He's got an employee, one of three in the department, that is going to go to school during her time after hours to learn how to write grants to save us more money. I think he's doing more than just his own job. He is the IT department, you know, so to speak, the security bulldog when it comes to the electronic highway. I mean, I work at Y-12 Federal Credit Union. At the credit union, we have an IT department. If my computer screen goes black, I don't go to my boss and say, I need a new screen, can you order one for me? I call IT and they drop what they're doing and they send somebody over because they've got 25 of them in a closet. They buy them in bulk. If a computer blows up, it's up to them to fix it, not me, not my boss. Ultimately, he should be compensated for what he's doing and has done. I would request that this issue goes, it was like you were saying, goes to the IT committee, ultimately HR, and then to us. It's not for any of us to write his job description or, you're right, figure out what it was that he's doing worth-wise, but he was hired on to do a job, and he's far exceeded those expectations.
I agree.
Sorry, you've got him bouncing all over.
Mr. Ed.
So, Commissioner Scott's right. That's what I was going to say. So the question is, Brian, who do you report to day to day?
Tim Shelton is my committee chair, and then Jeff Cole is my vice. I work with them.
Have you taken this information to them and asked them to bring a recommendation to either the HR committee or this committee?
That they basically told me to be here tonight for this, and we would discuss it then.
That's great. We appreciate you being here and bringing it to light, but for our purposes, just to follow protocol, I think we need to at least hear something out of that committee. Yay, nay, so many X dollars, you know.
Right.
That helps us.
That's kind of what I was waiting on, too.
So, Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we send Brian's request to the IT committee.
Second.
Got a motion, a second, discussion on the motion.
Brian, it seems like we got two issues here, your salary, and certainly that's something, you know, with some information that I'd be willing to look at, and I think, but then your workload, that your additional salary is not going to, you know, what you just described is a tremendous workload. That's kind of the other part of the.
We are.
So I just wanted to point out, I'd like to see how we're going to address possibly both of those sections.
That's what I'm saying, but we already had that today.
Oh, yeah.
Any more discussion?
I just had one thing.
Mr. Denver.
I was looking at this, and Brian, you can come up here and ask for a raise, but I wouldn't know if you needed more or less, and that was the point I was getting to. I don't know what a position of your sort should pay. So it's hard for me to determine if you need a raise or how much you need it. But, you know, our HR department's handed this out, and he's listed on here. Okay, there's a spot on here, which she's already done some research to see what people in his position are paid at other at other departments. So I agree. I think you should go to the HR and the IT committee and let them bring us back a recommendation.
Shane.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'll be brief. I came in on the tail end of the decision to create an IT department. And I think what may be scaring some of us is when we started this, we probably never envisioned that it would grow so quickly, you know, as fast as it has.
We didn't know what all we needed.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And one thing that, and I'm going to vote for the motion because I do think that committee and HR needs to be involved in these discussions. But at the same time, I would remind us, we certainly don't want to go backward, and we don't want to go back to where we were. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chuck.
I've got to get leave here because I got another meeting at 5:30 I got to go to that I'm chairman of. But I just want to bring up the fact, you know, this goes point through this disparity in wages and salaries and jobs that are being done that we're talking about throughout a lot of different positions throughout the whole county. One that I want to specify, and I've brought it up several times in the past and before, is when I first became a commissioner back in 2002, we had a law director and assistant law director, and they had a secretary, this, that, and the other. Now we just got a law director that puts in 70 probably plus hours a week trying to take care of all the different requests throughout the whole county and everything, and he basically lives out here, but he doesn't complain. He still works Friday, Saturday, Sunday if he has to. So that's something we need to look at probably sometime in the future is help for that man over there. If we keep putting on more and more and more, he don't need a raise. He needs some additional help.
Good point. Any more discussion? Brian, we've heard what you've asked.
Thank you.
In my opinion, we can't pay you enough.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate
so
y'all hearing
if
that.
If it comes down to my vote, I'd love to see you be compensated for what you do and what you mean to the county.
Thank you.
But it's going to go to the IT department, and it's up to them to tell us what direction to go.
Thank you. My goal at this department...
You got any pull with him?
No, I don't have any issues with Tim and all, and making that work.
Do you have any pull?
Pull.
With pull with him, with Sheldon? Well, I hope I do.
All right. Well, then we're through with you.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We need...
All in favor of the motion?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you. Well, I'm on nominating too. Well, yeah, what else we got in here, Robbie?
The last thing here is the capital outlay request, and I actually think we could just defer the next meeting because it changes, it changed again tonight. Well, you do have the two TIFs.
Yeah.
2 minutes.
Rick's gonna handle that, so.
2 minutes.
No.
I've got 10 questions.
10?
Mr. Mayor.
Defer to next meeting.
Sir?
You need to...
Oh, yeah, motion to defer the...
On our capital outlay, I got a motion to defer to next meeting. I got a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion, anybody opposed? Motion carries. Thank you. Now we're going to Mr. Meredith.
Okay, I want to bring the mayor up and yield to her on the first project of one of the TIFs. And while she's coming up, these are pictures of each one. I have them labeled of the three TIF projects that'll be on our agenda next Monday. So there's no action that has to be made by budget committee. This is just for information only to answer any questions you might have. So the mayor's been coming to the industrial board meetings where these have been vetted, so I want her to start off with Project Black Horse.
Yes, Project Black Horse, they've been working on this for, I guess, about a year and a half on this particular project. And if you look in your package, you'll see the resolution that they're requesting approval for. And the reason it's coming to budget is... at the finance level, we basically kind of upped the exposure for the TIF project, so there's a full vetting and there's an opportunity for comment instead of just coming before the full commission. This particular project, if you'll look, the page 2 labeled A has the expected benefits to the city and county. If you look, the city and county are expected to receive substantial additional sales tax revenues as a result. When retail operations are at projected sales volume, the annual local sales tax revenue generated is projected to be approximately $661,000. The TIF amount has a ceiling amount in terms of the development cost, not to exceed $660,000. And this is, and this particular project is true infrastructure. They're actually proposing redoing the, if any of you are familiar with that area, there is a road that's diagonal, kind of parallel to the Highway 61 there, the main road.
It's old Highway 61.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And they are going to, part of this proposal will be to straighten that road, and then that will provide some traffic relief, especially during the peak hours there, and that will go through and wind up there by the, what's that hotel there, Rick, where it'll, the road will come out?
Country Inn Suites.
Yes, yeah. So, I mean, this is a true infrastructure, doing some road work. It'll also hopefully solve some problems for folks that you've probably seen online or maybe had reach out to you there at Hunter's Trail Subdivision. It should improve life for those folks as well as part of this project. Hmm.
100 jobs.
100 jobs.
Yes. How long is that year-wise?
TIF?
Yeah.
8.3 million dollars. So to that point, currently, they're paying taxes of $24,000, and they'll pay taxes of $123,000 just by the improvements.
Say that again, please, Rebecca.
The current taxes paid on that vacant property is $24,515. It'll go to $123,580.
$123,500?
Yep.
And it was $25,000.
Before.
And which, exactly which property? This is the old...
This is the old Shell station at that square the mayor's referring to.
How much property is that?
It's on this...
It's Glen Alpine, right?
Yeah, it's this drawing right here. That's the first phase that goes on Charles Severs, and that's the road behind it will be improved. These two parcels back here are being open for either apartments or a big box.
Is that included, though? The two parcels behind is also included in the TIF?
That's correct. Well, this is what's included in TIF because it's the infrastructure.
Okay.
When you run the infrastructure here, it'll fund those. So there's two other, real quick, two other projects I'll go through real quick. That was the first one, which is the largest project up there. The second one's Tractor Supply. They are proposing a development next to Fox Toyota. If you don't know the story about the Fox Toyota property, ever since I've had this job, in at least the last 11 years, we've tried to land a project on that parcel. And now we've got a national retailer willing to do that. So just a little background on it real quick. It's their typical 34,000 square foot new construction Tractor Supply, so it's their new look. There's a picture of it I passed around. Their projected annual sales are $3,500,000 in a year. That's a $96,000 in sales tax that we would get.
Is that going to be in the city?
Yes, sir, as well as the county.
Okay, so my question with regards to the Tractor Supply is, what kind of an impact does that put on to our co-op?
No, the Tractor Supply focuses on what they call mini farmers, people less than 2 acres. So when the chamber did our marketing data for them, all the data was north and south of 75. We didn't market anything this way because the co-op focuses more on larger farmers, mm-hmm. larger equipment. Tractor Supply does not do that.
Okay.
It's a totally I know there's a lot of confusion on social media. And you know, why does the co-op not get a TIF? Well, mm-hmm. my uncle started the co-ops 80 years ago. So, I mean, it's just the way we're doing. We would never get these projects without a TIF proposal.
Why is that?
Because it's an incentive that offsets their payment in building and in constructing.
But we've never had a TIF. We've got everything up there at the interstate. The only thing up there with a TIF is that new hotel that was a big rush job, and they've not done anything. They've not done nothing.
They just got their finance to prove. Our part was the easy part.
I get that, but you know, for me, everything, that's prime real estate up there, guys. I mean, it's prime. They've already, Tommy Hicks and Tim George, they've already done the work for us up there. They built a lot of buildings up there, and they brought a lot of business. And if these guys can't make it with our tax rate, then that tells me our tax rate's too high. I can't look at 20-year TIFs for when we just raise taxes on our people, and we're going to say, let these companies come in and not pay their fair share. I know they bring in revenue, but the revenue doesn't help our general fund.
The sales tax does.
It helps our schools.
Well, we just funded the schools.
I know, but we can't take back from the schools. I mean, so it's just extra.
And my only concern with this is you've got one piece of property that is essentially five businesses.
Correct.
That's asking for assistance as opposed to a national chain.
Correct.
And I do believe
they're that big for a reason.
It will hurt. It will hurt co-op.
I believe it would.
The people up in Andersonville, they are going to stop at Tractor Supply and buy fence posts as opposed to going on towards Clinton and buying from co-op. My district's been very clear to me about TIFs, and they were not happy about the 10-year TIF for the hotel. They were very unhappy about that, and I know that they're not going to be happy with a 20-year.
Mr. Vowell.
Are you asking for a motion here tonight to send it on?
No, this is information only.
Okay.
Our procedure sends it to full commission. I was just bringing it to you all for questions, so you wouldn't have to ask them in full commission. I'm doing operations committee as well.
And I appreciate that, Rick. Appreciate the opportunity. When we were discussing the hotel TIF a while back, a developer in the north end of the county in our district was mentioned, and I think Commissioner Isbell made the comment, and I agree with him 100%. My understanding of TIFs, and please correct me if I'm wrong, was that they were originally designed to help bring in development in areas that were having a more difficult time, I think.
Impoverished.
Yeah, which I would certainly love to see a development in the north end of the county. And we have some up there, one of them's here tonight, that would be more than willing to maybe develop more if they had the property, if TIFs were available to them. I'm kind of leaning toward Denver on this one. I got some feedback from our constituents up in the 4th District as well. They're not very comfortable with us, especially a 20-year. I'd also have some questions that I don't know if you can answer. Are these the same owners of the Tractor Supply in the La Follette area?
No.
Okay, totally different people. Okay.
This is corporate.
I've done a little bit of research, and I'm not for sure on my facts, so I'll refrain from mentioning anything right now, but there was a history up there with the TIF, I think.
Up?
La Follette.
Oh.
But anyway, if it's not the same people, it doesn't matter. But I have to admit, if it comes to full commission, I'm going to be kind of hesitant to support this. Teresa mentioned the co-op. I'll throw another question out there. How will it affect Tractor Supply in Oak Ridge?
It won't.
Okay. They're thinking
not according to their corporate.
I got you.
They will not cannibalize other stores.
Okay.
That's why they did their marketing data before they ever brought the proposal.
If they go to Rocky Top this, I'd support a TIF because they need it. I mean, y'all need it up there. You get off at the 122 and you look at the difference between the 122 and the 28 and 29. It's a huge difference.
We don't choose these.
I know.
These sites. These sites are chosen by them for their reasons.
And with two exits up there, prime real estate, Mr. Cox sitting in the back has tried several times for several years to entice more and more to come in there. I think he told me one time Dollar General up there brings in more than any Dollar General in our area. Is that right, Gordon?
I'm sure they do, especially since you ain't got a grocery store.
So you need to understand something. With a TIF, Oak Ridge did the entire mall on a TIF approved by this body before you guys.
Yeah.
It's all fairness. I'm fine if you're opposed, but I would just say think about the financing. I understand the 20 years, but Rocky Top has this, their council passed this same resolution that this body gets. You know, we're trying our best to recruit up there as well. And when this exchange gets full, it's gonna continue to go north. Just like Emory Road's full, so they're coming here now. You know, in this body, passed a resolution, and you pay, you know, my job in the chamber is to recruit retail. And this is a tool, just like industry, where we have to recruit it. So if you're got heartburn about 20 years, you just think about this sales tax, which equals about $850,000 on all three of them. And Christy Hicks's project, which is the next one I want to talk about, includes 56 new houses that is not TIFed. It's just the frontage and the part with the retail. It just helps offset their cost. Also, the new Taco Bell next to the hotel is not TIFed. The three projects down here on the other side, which we're adding another Dollar General, to your point about that, that gives four Dollar Generals in Clinton. They're just, they see the market. None of that down there is TIFed. And we can go on with commercial property all the way to Food City. You know, my job is to recruit them with the county, whether it's Oliver Springs, Rocky Top, Clinton. I don't choose the site, especially if it's like a Tractor Supply. That's a corporate decision. Because this is a new store. They do two different models. New store, and then they go into like an old Kmart building with that same development they have in Oak Ridge. It's two different models.
What does the Hicks project, what does it consist of?
She's got 30,000 square feet right next to Walgreens. She owns that lot. That will be you saw the picture, the color picture. She's going to have four storefronts in the front. And in the back, down the road with the service road, she's going to put 56 new houses.
Okay. So the houses don't qualify for anything. It's just the storefront?
It's called a mixed use tip, yes.
And what are they asking for? Is it 20-year also?
Cannot remember hers. It's in the packet.
Okay.
I don't remember Denver.
Did you say it was mixed use?
I'm sorry?
Mixed use.
They call it mixed use when you're doing houses.
Mr. Moffett, question.
Just kind of a general question about TIF. As the project, a TIF project is developed, do property taxes increase, and is that money then devoted to paying off the...
It pays off the TIF anytime you go through reassessment. For instance, somebody builds an extra tractor supply, their property is going to go up. Somebody builds, if you develop the backside of this one, their property value is going to go up. And as it goes up, it pays the TIF off quicker. That's exactly what happened with Aldi and Aubrey's in Oak Ridge. They TIFed the red light and that parcel for those two. Well, they did a 10-year TIF and paid it off in 6 years because of the increased value in taxes. These are just estimates.
Mr. Val.
Rick, what kind of audit procedures are in place with this? Do we keep an eye on them during this time period and see?
All the finance, there is no risk to the county whatsoever, zero. It is their loan, it's their financing document.
And I know the mayor mentioned it was, this one was specifically for infrastructure, but if they wind up coming in under what's been proposed, what do they do with the extra?
There's no extra, that's the cap.
That's it.
Mm-hmm. And it was mentioned in the industrial board, so if they're asking for 600,000 and only spend 540, mm-hmm. that's all they get.
Gordon, you got any questions you'd like to ask if the chairman will permit you?
I'm Gordon Cox, I live in Andersonville, Hillville.
Chairman of the council member, I'm Gordon Cox, I live on Hillville Road in Andersonville. I'm really a supporter of TIFs over tax abatement, but I think TIFs is a situation that's really got to be scrutinized with real rigid policy. I can see almost anyone spending $3 million coming in front of you folks here in the future. And, there's a lot of issues. It's hard to understand a 20-year payout. I mean, a lot of us in the room be passed on in 20 years, you know. But when you look at it, when I think TIFs, I think of economic deprived areas, or it's a purpose to do a project that would not have happened without a TIF, or it's a purpose to do any type of business that comes in front of you that qualifies. And I guess what's included, that's the thing that's really, I thought years ago the purpose was infrastructure, getting the roads improved, intersections, traffic lights, getting sidewalks, getting the sewer line to the project. And now it's kind of extended within the parcel itself, doing the parking lot, retention, detention ponds, you know. And I guess the thing that when I asked the industrial board the other day a couple of questions, and they were very informative, and I appreciate the opportunity to talk to them, is that these people are asking for the max. It's 20%. And I think both these projects are 20-year financing. And I think if the project, if we're asking for 620,000 and if it comes in less than 620, I got the impression from them that if they request from the state, they can get permission to use the excess money for, I guess, bricks and mortar. And I got the impression it doesn't come back to county commission for their approval. It goes to the industrial board for their approval. I guess the other thing of it is that's basically it. I think you got to have some real guidelines because you're fixing to have a lot of folks that come in front of you all. Now, I asked Michael Foster, I remodeled the Hillbilly, spent a lot of money on it. I asked Michael, would I qualify for a TIF? And he said, you would not qualify, you're not spending enough money. It is true, I understand, that the city did say that a $3 million minimum would be the amount in Rocky Top. I think each community needs to look at that. I mean, $3 million spent in Rocky Top is very unique situation. I've done the first building in Rocky Top since 2010, Wiggins. So it's been 9 years since I've done something. And if anybody qualifies, I mean, to me, I really would qualify. It's three units. I've got one tenant. I've had one inquiry in a year on the other two empty units. And it's a situation that to me would really qualify because of the environment up there. But anyway, I just recommend you all to really scrutinize this because you got two now. and you'll have a lot more of them to look at. So appreciate the opportunity to talk to you.
Thank you, Mr. Collins.
Thank you.
Any more discussion?
Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
To Mr. Cox's point, the city of Rocky Top did approve $3 million, but it is up to their council to lower that. You can do a TIF for $200,000. And that was discussed at the industrial board. So, you know, it's not up to commission. It would be up to their council to take action on that. It's still become to this committee, but it's each city's right to put wherever they want
to set the amount,
the minimum amount of spend. We try to be uniform. We started at $5 million. We reduced it to $3 million. And that was done by the industrial board. The other thing is these projects are vetted by two engineers and a banker through the industrial board. They have to have a review committee. They review the entire estimate, the entire cost. They make sure everything is for infrastructure. There's no bricks and mortar. That is not eligible. Mm. And I can assure you the state will make sure of that. Mm. So.
Not to bring up the old thing, but I really dug into this since we had that first one. That was my first one, and I didn't support it. But we gave a tip to somebody to build a hotel where there was a hotel was there before. It burnt down. There's not a lot of infrastructure that they needed there. There was a nice road in there. I mean, everything was set up. So I guess I didn't understand what are they spending that money on? Do you know?
They're spending it on infrastructure. First of all, it had an outdoor pool. They're doing an indoor pool. It's all about the design.
I know, but that's...
It's 95 rooms compared to 33. I mean, you're talking about an apple and an orange when it comes to cost. That there is all kinds of issues with the road. When you're going down to a Taco Bell because it's shared by the other development, there's underground detention ponds that are gonna have to be moved. That new hotel doesn't fit the old hotel as far as design. That's where their costs are going.
Okay.
So without, to Denver's point, unless you know all these details, you're seeing monies that shouldn't be spent unless you know these.
That is correct. Yeah. That's the whole purpose of our industrial board and why that is their job. So and the other point I want to make to the mayor as well as Mr. Cox, right now our policies and procedures for TIFs do not include going to operations and or the budget committee. So when these three go up or down, I'm going to work to change that policy, and if Rocky Top wants to change theirs, I'll be glad to help them. I helped them with the first one. But, you know, these policies are made to be adjusted. They're not set in stone. This group can change that with the help of the industrial board.
Good. Good.
Well, they're paying big money for property up at the interstate. I mean, I think that one piece of property sold for $900,000 here just a little ways back. And I guess my point is their developers paying $900,000 for a small piece of property, and then they're coming looking at us to give them a tax break.
But just remember, you do the same thing for industry in a reverse role.
For what?
You do the same tax break for an industry as you do this. It's the same concept, except it's reversed. Go tell your constituents you want to pay a $100,000 pilot when their taxes should probably be $500,000.
Well, but the schools are, I mean, the retail tax, it's all about the retail.
Sales.
It's not
that's the spirit. That's the difference in the retail and industry. Industry's right. About jobs, retail's about sales tax.
Right, and that's my issue with it. If we were getting money in our general fund to fund the services that we're gonna have to provide, then that would be one thing, but we're not. We're the retail tax is all going to the schools.
I would just go on record to say this, and we can move on, Mr. Chairman. Don't get hung up on the 20-year because their property values are going to go up, not down.
It'll be paid off quicker.
In the 20, it'll be paid off much quicker. All you got to do is ask Oak Ridge. That's the only thing I'll say about your 20-year.
We got about 3 minutes. Let's wrap it up.
Nope, I'm done, Mr. Chairman.
Everybody stay through? Good. Good.
Thank you.
Did they get back? Oh, okay. I hadn't been on my email much. Thanks. I appreciate the update. Oh, yeah.
I forgot which committee I was on. I forgot. You didn't know where you were.
I was confused. I thought this was sending Rusty Wallace a bill, $250,000 for those 2 years of parking his truck to make up the difference.
Sorry. I thought we were off by one.